My request to our family here, to my brothers, because those superior to me, I cannot say anything. I am taking instruction from them. But those who are youth, you know, my brothers sitting here, I can share my heart. My concern or my main anxiety is Srila Prabhupada's disciples worked all their life to protect ISKCON. Now they are all in their 70s. What is going to happen to our movement 10 years from now? 10, 15 years from now, all these moons of Prabhupada's family, from whom we are hearing Prabhupada Katha, will go back home, back to Godhead. What happens later? ISKCON will fall onto our shoulders, each one of us, the youth sitting here. And our principle in life should be, I want to make my life successful. I want to spread and make others' life successful. I not just want to maintain the standards of ISKCON, I want to bring it higher for the pleasure of Prabhupada. This should be ours. The generation before us have given their life for Prabhupada. You see, they're all still traveling. Look at all the sannyasis, look at all the great Prabhupada disciples. They're in their 70s. They're still traveling the globe, giving Harikatha. What are we doing? You know, my brothers and my Prabhus here. What are we doing? Are we taking Prabhupada's books and Prabhupada's mission seriously? Are we just giving lip service and saying Jai Prabhupada, or are we taking it in our heart? Mukhe bole? Only saying through the lips, or really in the heart? We don't want lip service. Prabhupada doesn't want just Jai Prabhupada. He wants us to say Jai Prabhupada through spirit, through our actions, through our vichar, achar and prachar. So we all have to team up. Hum nahi karenge to kaun karenge? So we all have to hold hands and serve Prabhupada's ISKCON